Hello, chess friends. This is FIDE Master Lilov for Chess.com, and in my lecture now, I would like to finish the series of lectures from the Grunfeld Defense with a game that was played actually 11 years ago between the great players Vladimir Kramnik and Garry Kasparov on the Siemens Giants Open close to Grandmaster Tournament. In fact, this game is very interesting with the fact that both of the players played quite an interesting variation of the Grunfeld, and it was really a big fight until they really get the draw. I want to show you this because the game is full with instructive and in the same time quite important theoretical moments. Okay, so Vladimir Kramnik was white, and he actually started with the move d4, against which black played knight up to f6. Pawn at the c4 and g6. Okay, we have the initial moves of the Grunfeld defense right now: knight c3 and pawn at the d5. White exchanged, and then black simply recaptured with his knight. We have the key position, in which white's key move is pawn at d4. We have seen the other continuations, and we also notice that they don't work particularly strong. So that's why white chooses to play e4 right now, after which black exchanges the two knights, knight takes to c3, and after b takes to c3, eventually black does bishop g7. Now, basically after the move of bishop g7, black's bishop is very well protecting around the black king. And as we know from the previous lectures, c7 up to c5 is a move that will follow possibly next. White did knight up to f3, and black immediately pushed c5. Of course, white has quite a few different ways to play this position. There is a way to play h3, there was a way to play bishop d3 and knight e2 with an idea of f3, and there is also this way, which white chose right here. It's a very popular now the continuation coming with rook to b1 from white's side. Usually this move involves the opportunity for white to prepare his pieces, like for example bishop e2, castling short, eventually this rook can be involved into the attack on the b file and so. In any case, it somehow makes it more difficult for black to bring out his light square bishop or do something sufficient. And so after rook b1, castles on the short side, white played bishop to e2. Now we arrive at one of the key positions of that line. After bishop e2, it's usually very common to see black capturing on d4, since that kind of exchange helps him to quickly change to trade off those pawns on c5 and c3 that are not really necessary for black. He can go without those, and now basically he may have the chance to attack towards the queen side directly. There are quite a few different possibilities, but what black came with was the move of queen a5 check. Now this is a very smart possibility. The idea of this move is to provoke.
We hope you enjoyed this video demo from Chess.com. Subscribe today to finish this video and get unlimited access to our full video library. Your membership also includes access to Chess Mentor, the most advanced interactive training tool available anywhere. You'll also get full access to the Opening Explorer, Tactics Trainer, and much, much more. So sign up today and get serious about improving your game.